Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm Shu Chasega from Japan Society of Engineering Geology. Today, I'd like to talk about engineering geology in active mountain belt, application knowledge from Japan to the Himalaya. The first half is of my presentation is based on my research in Japan. And second half of my my presentation is correlative research with Professor Ranjan Kumar Dahal of Tribhuvan University, Nepal. So he's a co-author. Aim of this presentation is to provide background and characteristics of topography and geology of the Himalaya and Shikoku, Japan. To provide engineering geological issues on hydrothermal alteration due to Miocene volcanism. And to provide engineering geological issues on large-scale landslide and active faults. And to promote correlative research on engineering geology for disaster risk reduction and sustainable development in the Himalayas. Let me first introduce tectonic setting of Himalaya and Japanese archipelago. The Himalaya is situated on the collision zone of Indian plate under the Eurasian plate. On the contrary, Japan is situated over the subduction zone of Pacific and Philippine Sea plate under the Eurasian plate. In spite of the different tectonic setting, the Himalaya and the south of Japan have similar engineering geological issues. Japan is an earthquake country. We have severe damage earthquake in 2011 and 1995. The Kobe earthquake is a Japan has suffered great damage from massive intra-plate earthquake produced by plate subduction, such as 2011 Tohoku earthquake. And inland cluster earthquakes caused by active faults, such as the 1995 Kobe earthquakes. Large-scale earthquakes are still a great threat to Japan. Japan is also a typhoon country. Japan lies in the northeast tip of the Asian monsoon zone. Typhoon is a cause of flood and landslide in Japan. Let's turn into Himalaya. Everybody knows the Himalaya has been formed as a result of collision of Indian and Eurasian plate. Along the boundary, big earthquake, Himalaya has suffered great damage from massive intraplate earthquakes produced by plate subductions. This is one interpretation of Golka earthquake. The mechanism and is interpretation of this earthquake is still discussing. And landslide is many landslides triggered by Nepal earthquake. This figure shows distribution of density of earthquake triggered landslide. And Himalaya is a high difference elevation in short distance, so flooding and rainfall induced landslide are frequent in monsoon season during summer. In spite of different tectonic setting, the Himalaya and southeast Japan represent similar topographic profile. This, you can see, Higher Himalaya is correlated to Shikoku Mountains. The Tibet is this Chugok region, and Ganga Plain is Philippine Sea Plate. So we talk about this area. Geological engineering problem in the Himalaya and Shikoku Mountains are similarly mainly attributed to extreme relief, very steep and rugged topography, weak rock mass due to hydrothermal alteration and landsliding, and strong South Asian monsoon and typhoon, and earthquakes. Let me first review my research in Shikoku. Engineering Shikoku issues in Shikoku Mountains is like this. And South East Japan is subducted by a Philippine Sea Plate around Nankai Trough. Shikoku is situated on the subduction zone. So, and volcanic front is back arc side of the island arc. So Shikoku Mountain is located non-volcanic region. This figure shows the regional geological map of Shikoku and around the area. This is median tectonic line, one of the most active fault in Japan. And the northern part is Ryoke Belt, mainly composed of Cretaceous granite. And southern part is Sambaga-Chichibu-Shimant Belt. It is Mesozoic and Paleogene accretional prisms. This is a geologic profile of southern Japan. Median tectonic line is this, and Shikoku Mountain is located like this. South of Japan arc were formed during by subduction tectonics, which include both formation of accretional prisms and intrusion of granite. Although Shikoku is located non-volcanic region, Kotonai non-volcanic region, the Miocene granite beneath Mesozoic and Paleogene accretional prism have played important role in mountain building and engineering geology. The most interesting fact is highest mountain in Shikoku and hot spring the southern West Japan is closely related to Miocene granite bodies. This is a hot spring in Key Peninsula. This is Kaohsiung, says it is very hot water because 90 degrees centigrade. And this source is this is Kotonai non-volcanic region. Heat source of hot spring is inferred to be residual heat of the Miocene granite intrusive bodies. And ore deposit originated from shallow hydrothermal alteration during after Miocene granite intrusion are widely distributed in Shikoku, especially along the MTL. Median tectonic line. And engineering geological issue in Shikoku Mountain is related to hydrothermal alteration in non-volcanic regions. Serious geoengineering trouble have occurred during large-scale construction work in Shikoku. This is a slope failure of cut road, a cut slope during construction of a highway. And cause of this landslide is due to the sliding surface of rhyolite originated clay zone. Swift surface composed of smectite-rich clay originated from hydrothermal alteration due to Miocene rhyolite intrusion. This is a it looks like shallow runs, right? But it is a part of deep sea landslide. This landslide occurs triggered by earthquakes, and this is simultaneously a crack and a shallow landslide occurred. So in the Shikoku Mountain, we must take care of large scale run, deep sea landslide when some small scale shallow runs would happen. And engineering geological issue in Shikoku Mountain is related to large scale landslide behind the small scale landslide. Let me show a very old landslide mass, but normally it was not recognized as landslide because the topography is completely dissected. This is like here, separated here from active fault MTL. But this is restoration of this mass indicates that this mass was there and slid across the MTL and dislocated two or three kilometers after landsliding during 1 million years. And our study research in Japan revealed that relation between formative age and degree of dissection of large-scale landslide in Japan is like this. The topography of large-scale landslide have been completely dissected after 1 million years. So there are the possibility of dissected landslide body mass along the active fault. Let me show some relation of active fault and landslide. This is a very sharp fault scarp of median tectonic line, and this is very not clear. This is very sharp topography, and it became very obscure. We tried helicopter-borne electric magnet method to detect smectite-bearing clay zone and as a low resistivity zone. This is a helicopter. This is a result of resistivity survey by him along the MTL. Active fault MTL is here, and red zone is low resistivity zones. It is due to hydrothermal alteration. Let me talk about some tunneling issue along the MTL. There are many tunnels around the MTL, but lithology is not useful to estimate rock mass grade and conversion during tunnel around the MTL. So we divided the rock hill tunnel of four types, which is non-affected landslide, affected landslide, affected non-affected hydrothermal alteration, not affected hydrothermal alteration. So the entropy is very the good rock mass. And HS type is worst type. And S type is landslide. H type only hydrothermal alteration. This is rock mass grade by the observation of phase. The N type is very good condition, but and S type and HS type is worse bad condition. But conversion of this type tunnel is different. S type is not conversion is of S type is not large, but H type and conversion of H type and HS type is also what? 5 minutes? Yes. Yeah. It takes time. So the most important thing we should notice the sign of hydrothermal alteration. Let's go to the Himalaya. Himalaya is the same condition. The higher Himalaya is Miocene granite distribute in higher Himalaya zone and played important role in mountain building and engineering geology. This is a Ryukyu granite. And we published a paper on the cause of large-scale landslide in Lesser Himalaya. In this paper, we propose the Miocene Ryukyu granite of very important role. The uplift of higher Himalaya are closely related to Miocene granite. The important fact during the Golko earthquake is higher Himalaya zone subsided as a result of thrusting during Golko earthquake. And distribution of Miocene granite and hot spring is closely related. Hot spring is arranged along the main in central thrust. This is the one of the hot spring. And hydrothermal alteration, which might have been taking place due to granitization of Miocene granite in the higher Himalaya zone, is a geological cause of deep sea landslide. This is our hypothesis. This is a sliding surface of landslide. The sliding surface is formed by a hydrothermal alteration. And this is a shallow landslide. But behind the shallow landslide, there is a large scale landslide, deep sea landslide. This is a profile of this landslide. And at this place, also sliding surface is formed by hydrothermal alteration. The clay minerals are mainly chlorite and sericite. So we propose the hypothesis of this figure. But I don't have time, so let's go next. The geological condition is very similar, and there are many large-scale landslides behind the shallow landslide in the Himalaya. Large-scale landslides well known in Lantang Valley. This is a famous mega landslide. And Tansen is a part of mega landslide. Tansen is in Lesser Himalaya. The scar first stage landslide might be like this, and second stage like this. And let's go. Let's see. This is a landslide topography. Landsky scar is eroded and valleys is formed. The gentle slope is composed of crushed rock. like this. Gentle slope below the eroded scar consists of disturbed rock mass and open cracks. Fragile rock mass of the Himalaya was not caused by tectonic activity, but surface deformation by ancient mega landslide. That's my opinion. If the landslide is old enough and dissected, there is no topography. I'd like to try this research in Himalaya, but not yet. Finally, I'd like to propose some hypothesis of origin of Kathmandu Valley. Origin of Kathmandu Valley should be re-examined from point of view from landslide dams, because Kathmandu Valley is very extraordinarily wide and high in elevation. Outlet is southern part of Kathmandu Valley. There is a large-scale landslide, but it's too small to dam up to form Kathmandu Valley. Our hypothesis is main outlet of Kathmandu Valley might located the upper stream of Tulisiri River. This is a landslide block mass. This is also landslide the mass, we suppose. So Kathmandu Valley, we now try to get evidence from this mega landslide, but not yet. Can you imagine? This is a landslide body. This also landslide body. Of course, this is landslide, which is a later stage. So, tunnel construction might be prove our hypothesis, I hope. And one thing, why this large-scale mega landslide occurs? One reason, one trigger is landslide. Thank you. Yeah, we propose another extension of this active fault. Thank you for kind attention.